We're looking at a new grow light from Active Grow, the LoPro Max. Active Grow did send me this LED to keep, so I can continue to test it, and I'm grateful. But we'll take an honest look at this light so you can decide if it's right for you. Active Grow hit my radar in 2017 with LEDs designed to replace T5 fluorescent bulbs. I've tested a similar product, perfect for things like lettuce, clones, seedlings, and herbs. Today, this company is still around offering these brand new high watt systems. These aren't for seed starting hobbyists growing pepper seedlings 2 months per year. Well, maybe ones like that. IP65 enclosures are dust tight and protected against water spray. In professional, controlled environment agriculture, you need lights designed for safety and reliability. Looking at the form factor, the LoPro Max has 4 strips of diodes covering a broad footprint, more consistent coverage at tighter mounting heights than HIDs. Kind of like a T5 fluorescent, but much less heat per watt. And the open construction greatly improves airflow. It also means less shade effect. In a greenhouse setting, 60% of the footprint is open, allowing natural sunlight to reach your plants. All the while, you get light output rivaling HPS lights. This light has an external dimming knob, so really, this single fixture can replace 2 very different technologies. Dimmed down to 50%, you can start out with clones or seedlings, just like T5s. But when plants mature and light requirements go up, no problem. Just crank the output to 100% and you have HID light levels. Whether you have a rack system or a sea of green application, these LEDs are an all-in-one solution. All right, but how does the 320 LoPro stack up against an HID? Many LED sellers falsely claim their light can replace super high watt HIDs, but modern HIDs are twice as bright as older models. Clearly, the 320 LoPro Max can't compete with 750 or 1000 watt HPS lights, but the 640 LoPro would be a good replacement. As for the 320, that LoPro Max would outperform a top of the line 400 watt HPS, or it gives single-ended 600 watt HPS lights a run for their money. With LED versus HIDs, something else to consider is directionality. With LEDs, the diodes send photons downward. You get a tighter target area with more photons actually reaching your plants. They sent me a couple PPFD maps at both 12 and 24 inches from the canopy. No light overlap, no side reflection. These charts show standard PAR photons. I was curious, how would side reflection impact those numbers? I created a 48 by 28 inch growing space, similar to a 2x4 foot grow tent. Looking at Active Grow's 12 inch light map, we see how light levels are boosted with side reflection over a more proportionate growing area. Some pretty high light levels in a grow chamber. Raising the light to 18 inches, the PPFD drops, but the photons are distributed more evenly. What if you dim it to 50%? At half power, you have half the light. What about getting closer? Here's a map at 6 inches. It's twice as bright in the center, but you have a 12-hour DLI in the 40s. Let's remove the side reflection. Clearly, 24 inches by 44 inches is an optimal coverage area at this height. On average, 50% power translated into 54% of the light output. But these standard PAR maps only tell part of the story. In addition to their original readings, Active Grow also sent me these ones. These PFD values were 7% higher on average. Why is that? Because these are PBAR readings. No. PBAR stands for Plant Biologically Active Radiation. We've known for a long time that plants use all photons between 400 and 700 nanometers to fuel photosynthesis. Yes, that's right, even green photons. But as it turns out, plants respond to even more photons than that. The PBAR spectral range spans from UV at 280 nanometers all the way to 800 nanometers where we find far red radiation. The LoPro Max Entourage spectrum has diodes devoted specifically to far red, 7% in fact. When mixed with the white photons, plants experience a synergistic effect, known as the Emerson enhancement effect. This results in even more growth than one would expect for the number of photons emitted. Plants can actually use these far red photons for photosystem 1. Growth trials have shown increased budding and trichome formation. We hope to see more research on that in the future. So back to the LoPro. The standard PPF efficacy is 2.4 micromoles per joule. When you add in those far red photons, the efficacy goes up by 7%. The PPF output is 768. Add in the missing 7% far reds and you hit 822. That explains the boost in values shown in active grow's PBAR based light maps. If you're interested in converting my standard PPFD maps into PBAR values for this light, just multiply by 1.07. So, what are my final thoughts on Active Grow's LoPro Max LED luminaire? I really like it. It's lightweight with a fairly open construction. It can be treated like a linear light source rather than a point source, meaning nice, even coverage at tight mounting heights. The dimmer makes for a very flexible system. It destroys high output T5 fluorescent lights with well over twice the efficacy. But it also keeps up with high-end HPS lights, requiring notably less power. Active Grow has two models. The 320-watt system is great for small-scale, high-end growers, a perfect fit for 2-foot by 4-foot grow tents. That's really where this LED shines. It might be good for certain vertical racking systems too. But if you're looking for larger, broader areas of coverage, then you need to scale up. The 640-watt model is the way to go. The larger footprint prevents me from using it in my normal growing space, you know, a shower stall. So that's one mark against the LoPro. But for most users, that won't be an issue. Really, this seems like a solid product that ought to perform well. I hope this info has helped you out. I appreciate your support on my channel. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. Please subscribe. And as always, I'd like to wish you some happy gardening.